And so anyway, you know, it's water under the bridge now, huh? Okay, let's get back to what we're doing here. We're going to be talking tonight about the disease of liberalism, as I like to call it. And the reason I call it a disease is because it's based and founded in a sense of victimization. And the one common thread you'll find in most real hardcore liberals is they always feel victimized. They're always angry about something, and they always feel like they're getting the short end of the stick. And therefore, everybody else should be making amends to them and making things better for them, because after all, they have no control of what's going on. They're a victim of circumstances, and it's everybody else's fault. I'm going to share with you a couple of things to kind of illustrate this tonight. I'm going to pull an article here by, Ann Coulter. One of my favorite conservatives. I know a lot of people don't like her because she's just too honest. But, you know, I happen to like the woman. I think she's a great writer, a great commentator, or pundit, as the liberals like to refer to them. Anyways, this is an article that just came out here. She posted this on the 28th of January, just a couple days ago. And the article starts out by saying, "I noticed that liberals have not challenged the overall thesis of my rocketing bestseller, Guilty, Liberal Victims and Their Assault on America," which is that her main thesis being that liberals always play the victim in order to advance, win advantages, and oppress others. And this is what the disease of liberalism does. It advances their agenda by doing just that. They want advantage, or they want to oppress others, and they want to advance themselves. And so what they do, it's kind of like that old thought, that old feeling that if I can't bring myself up to your level, I'll have to tear you down to mine. And then that's the level playing field that liberals like to play on. Okay, so the examples that she gives is the withdrawal by Carolyn Kennedy out of the recent Senate replacement. And we know Hillary Clinton was selected as our Secretary of State. Wait to see how that works out. But Carolyn Kennedy wanted to take her spot in the Senate. And apparently some stuff surfaced about her personal life, her family life, as if anybody should be sitting there going, duh. I mean, this is a Kennedy we're talking about. They all have problems in their personal life and married life. That's what makes them a Kennedy. There was these comments made that Chris Matthews was upset with one of his guests, Michael Shmierkanish, when he asked what her qualifications were, and Matthews was appalled that he would even ask that. And then it went on that political Ron Brownstein elaborated, saying, well, that's pretty rough. You know, you're rough because you're asking what her qualifications are. Well, I asked what her qualifications are. Outside of having the name of Kennedy, what qualifications does she have? But then again, there's never been any qualifications for the Kennedys. They're Kennedys, and therefore, they're able to do whatever they want to do. You know, kind of like, I don't know, it's a God thing, I guess. You know, God complex, whatever. But the whole point being is that you can't question what liberals believe, because liberals, because they believe it. You can't question me because I believe it. And if you do question them, then you're a racist, or you're an elitist, or you're judgmental. You know, so the idea being is, you know, every time you raise your voice, every time you say anything contrary to what I believe, then you're the one that's screwed up, because after all, I'm a liberal, and I'm the intellectual, and I'm the one that wants the level playing field, and therefore I'll tear everybody down that isn't on my level. And that way we'll all be in the same place at the same time, and we all get all kumbaya-y. You know, we can all sit around and make peace in the world singing kumbaya. But anyway, here's another article that kind of goes a little bit further with what I'm saying. It says here that this article is on Fox News, Tuesday, January 27th. Democrats launched petition against Rush Limbaugh after firing back at Obama. Rush Limbaugh made comments about Barack Obama, hoping that he fails in his administration. There's a reason for that. The guy's a screaming socialist, and those of us on the conservative side, those of us on the conservative side don't want to see socialism taking this country over. So yeah, we want him to fail. We know he's going to fail. It's just a matter of everybody else catching up with what we already know. Anyway, it says the Democratic Congressional Campaign Committee has launched an online petition to express outrage at conservative radio host Rush Limbaugh for saying he wanted President Obama to fail, as if an online petition is going to solve anything. But the idea here is we just want everybody to know that we're ticked off because Rush Limbaugh said something contrary to the Messiah, Barack Obama. Jobs, health care, and our place in the world, the stakes for our nation are high, and every American needs President Obama to succeed, the petition reads. Stand strong against Rush Limbaugh's attacks. Sign our petition telling Rush what you think of his attacks on President Obama. Let me translate the word succeed to you in liberal speak. Succeed means get along with us. This is exactly what Barack Obama said that elicited this response from Rush Limbaugh. Barack Obama said, you guys have to quit listening to Rush Limbaugh if you want to get along. That means if you're going to play our game, if you want to get along, if you don't want us out there destroying you as we do everybody else that doesn't agree with us, then you need to turn off Rush Limbaugh and listen to me, the Messiah, because after all, I have the written word, I am God. So anyway, having said that, I got to go to a break. We're going to finish. We're going to continue this in just a minute, but I got to get another break in here. And so you just hang with us here. You're listening to Right and Wrong on KTSTFM.com. We'll be right back.